Okay, I'll do a little more up close video on the Husqvarna Model 20 here. I got videos of the other one from like years ago and a couple shooting videos and stuff, but most of them are fairly sort of low quality with the old camera. So the stock, I remember in the other video, was pretty rough, like it had varnish or something on it and it was all scraped. I just linseed oiled the thing, so it's sort of in between the varnish. I didn't really feel like scraping all that off, and whatever. It's a working gun anyway, so. But so this is the Model 20. There's like Model 17s. There's like a bunch of different models, but they're under lever shotguns, which is kind of neat. It's a fairly old system that the Swedes kept making until like, I think it was 1945, if I remember right. And they got back action locks, which are sort of abnormal, but I think it's just the way that the gun is made that the lock pretty much has to be like, it has the springs that run the hammers or in behind. So anyway, but it, I don't know, to me I like back action locks. They get the gun nice lines. It sort of strengthens the wrist here. It's like the straight stocks or Inga style or whatever they call it. There was ones with the pistol grips, but I think they came later. You got two hammers. You got their rebounding hammers. You pull the trigger and you can push them forward. The spring-loaded firing pins. This one's double modified. I think I mentioned that before. Sling swivels on it. Steel butt plate, which is nice. These are really well built guns, but they were built to be used. So everything is like the steel butt plate, in my opinion, is way better for a working gun because if it gets bumped and it's like one of those hard rubber or whatever butt plates that get chipped and broken and stuff like that. And you still see the case hardening here. I think it was on all of the lock in here. I don't know if it was on the lever here. You can still see some of it here. So how these work, if you haven't, I got a ridiculously long barrel, so pull this lever this way and you can open the action, and there's a little lever here. You push that. See the other way, and then you can take the barrels off. So it is sort of a semi-complicated system in sort of way. It's a little bit of machining has to be done. But it has 20 written here, which is for Model 20. Here's your locking thing, where the sort of it's a sort of a T-shaped locking thing that goes into here. Extractor, a little lug that attaches it to the other part. See here, this one comes loose for some reason. See that's little locking thing is there, and that locks that on. See, this is like a T-shape thing that turns. When you turn it around, it locks into that. There's Model 20 written here as well. Can see the firing pin protrusion or not. They're spring-loaded firing pins. The thing's fairly advanced. And you can see this one, big burr right there. And that's from people trying to close it when it was the gun was open, or trying to just get bumped or whatever. Trigger guard, and your goes down all the way up to here. Pretty well put together, actually. And they, like I say, weren't terribly expensive. That's just a lot terribly expensive, but they're sort of an unknown, but I'll go get them known and ruin it, but whatever. They say Husqvarna Vapen Fabrics AB. Link over here. This one doesn't have the wavy stuff on the rib for some weird reason to cut down glare, but this is a double modifier. That's what it's supposed to be anyway. Let's see that or not. Girls look basically the same. I measured them and they were pretty sure they were in that range for like double modified. Most of them were, a lot of them were like double full modified. But it's a pretty nice gun for what they cost. So, the screw keeps coming loose for them, but it can't get out anyway because it's right up against the barrel here. So if it didn't want to back out, it can't go anywhere. But you can see the case hardening in here as well. It's really nice. This appears to be all milled out of a, I don't know if this was like a forging originally or if it was a casting and then they milled it, but this looks like a casting. This part here has some kind of roughness to it, but it's hard to tell. This here might be a forging that was milled out, because this is where it locks in there. So, and this just sort of supports the barrel, so not really, I think it's super necessary to be just sort of hook the back in there and then operates. Yeah. Push that back. Close the barrels. And this one's actually really tight. Like the other one I got, this thing will basically like almost fall open on its own. So that's another sort of reason why I want to get another one. The other one was a little bit more worn and kind of wanted to get another one while they were still available for a fairly decent price. So, but they're kind of nice too. Like they are, they're 2.5 inch, so you gotta kind of, unless you want to buy the there's legitimate smokeless powder ones, 2.5 inch shells you can buy, like Tradex sells them as well. But some of these ones I don't really know if I'd want to shoot. I'm pretty much sticking with like Pyrodex or black powder. Because I'm not going to buy the 2.5 inch or the 65 millimeter made ammo for it, so might as well just, I don't blast that many rounds of shotgun away every year anyway, so it's not a really big deal to me. But anyway, I kind of like them. Kind of a classy looking thing. They're kind of really old school, but they're fairly new. Like, I'm not sure what the age on this one is. That website that I keep mentioning is defunct, but I'm thinking the 1930s, at least. The ones with the pistol grips and stuff were the later ones, I believe. But this does look like it's beechwood. Like the earlier ones from like the 20s or early 30s, I think, were still walnut, most of them, but this looks like it's beech and has that weird cross grain thing going on. Still a good wood, it's just not as pretty as walnut, really, but anyway, so we'll probably get her out and try her out soon enough, see how she patterns. Double modify will be pretty good, it'll give it a little bigger pattern, so I'm not much of a shotgun shot, so. Or shotgun shooter. So anyway, thanks for watching. Hopefully that was not a bad video.